Hey everyone, it's not exactly fun seeing stories of melting RTX 5090s or 4080s or 5080s or whatever else, but luckily there's actually ways in HWiNFO of automatically shutting down your system if voltages drop too low, as I show off in this video. The first thing you need to do is make sure that HWiNFO actually starts up when your computer starts up automatically. I mean, you can do it manually, but obviously it might be that then you forget to have HWiNFO run. And then, you know, you have melting issues or something like that on the one time that you forget to actually manually run HWiNFO. So I like to actually make sure that it runs automatically. And one of the main ways of doing that is under HWiNFO in more recent versions. If you click on the settings, there's an option for auto start when Windows starts up. So you could do that. And then if you don't want it to get in the way, you could minimize sensors on startup, for example, and show sensors on startup if you want to go straight into sensors mode like I do. So you could do that, and then actually in many cases that does work. However, some people have actually had some issues with this starting up automatically. So there's another way of doing things, which is doing it yourself under Windows Task Scheduler, which is built into Windows, and I'll show that now. But first we need to actually get the path for the executable. So if you search for HWiNFO, go to open file location, then you can actually see the file location there. But basically if you right click and go to properties, you'll see the target there. So that is the full executable. And I should say as well, you need to install HWiNFO if you want to actually have it running automatically at system startup. If you're running HWiNFO in portable mode, you won't be able to do this. You just need to either make sure that you start it up manually or reinstall it as, you know, an installed executable and then do what I'm gonna show you. But you get that particular link, which for now we will just paste here. Don't worry about this other thing. But that is the actual executable location. It might be that that's the same for you anyway, if you just use the default location, but it's worth just double checking, you know, in here, just in case you've installed it somewhere else. Next, we want to go to Task Scheduler. I always run this as admin. It just makes sense. I think it does it anyway. So in here now, we need to, under the Task Scheduler library on the left, which will be automatically enabled, you go to Create Basic Task. In here, we'll say HWiNFO startup. Click on Next. When do you want the task to start? We're going to say when the computer starts. You can also say when I log on and stuff, but I just say when the computer starts, to be honest. Then start a program. And in there, we're going to paste, you know, what we had earlier, the executable path. It's better to have the double quote marks here because if there's a space, it'll mess up otherwise. So we'll keep that there. You can see that there. In this particular case, you shouldn't need arguments. Obviously, if there are any changes to this in a future update, I'll let you know down in the comments. But you paste that in there, click on Next, and that's going to be that. And then we want to open properties dialog when this is finished because we need to make a couple more tweaks. But in general, what this is going to do is start up HWiNFO when your system starts up. And in general, this is the most reliable way. Then in under the options here, you know, because we clicked on the properties option, go to run whether user's logged in or not, and run with the highest privileges. And that tends to be the most reliable way of getting this to actually work. Then we come over to triggers, and under there, what I like to do is click on edit, delay the task for 30 seconds or a minute. What that actually does is, you know, sometimes when the computer's just starting up, it's, you know, it can be slow. There's so much stuff starting up. If you don't delay the task, sometimes HWiNFO doesn't start up properly. So I do 30 seconds or 1 minute. I wouldn't do anything more though. So that's that. Click on OK. You need to log in and do all that. But then once that's all set up, that should mean the HWiNFO will start up automatically, you know, every single time you boot up. Do try that out though. So, you know, once you've set that up, restart your computer, make sure it works. If it doesn't, some other people have tried a few other things, which I'll also put down in the comments, but this seems to be the most reliable way of doing things. So make sure you do that if you're like me and forgetful and you don't want to manually start HWiNFO every time. Right, so that is that. Now we can actually start HWiNFO manually, or it might be automatically running. And we need to actually enable the alert on the sensors. So we click on start in sensors only mode. That's what I tend to do. We'll ignore the updates. I kind of do need to update that. So here you'll have all of your sensors, as you probably know. And one of the ones that I tend to like is if you've got an NVIDIA graphics card, you're gonna see the GPU, PCIe, 12 volt input voltage. There's a few different ones and you can see this is glitched up a little bit for me. But this particular one for me is the most reliable one to actually set an alert on. Now, this is obviously the 12 volt power connector. It should be running at 12 volts, obviously. But as part of the spec, there's a tolerance of plus or minus 5%. So essentially, at the moment, you can see mine is running at 12.35. Basically, if we times that by that, so basically there's a tolerance. So basically this figure can go up to around 12.6 and still be within tolerance. So that's plus 5, or it can go down to 11.4 and still be in tolerance. And actually everyone's graphics cards and power supply, you know, supplies are actually different. And as a result, you know, this figure will float around for everyone. The key thing though is you get used to what your figure is, both at idle and also when gaming or something else, because when you're gaming or running firm arc, in other words, stressing the graphics card, that figure will actually drop. So like for example, right now it's 12.35. If I then run firm arc and actually start stressing out the graphics card, I'll run it for a few seconds. And if we minimize that, what you'll actually see is the input voltage now is lower. It's now, well, sometimes it's 12.3, but actually it did dip down to 12.15. Sod's law now is probably not going to do that, is it? But in general, 12.2. You can see in the minimum anyway, it was 12.15. It only briefly shown that. But in general, when I'm gaming or running firm arc, my graphics card might run lower than that. It might actually, yeah, dip down a little bit. So what you've got to do is get used to what your graphics card tends to do under load. And then you want to set up an alert that will be below that value, because essentially if you do have problems with some of your cables melting or, you know, giving insufficient voltage, what's going to happen is actually this input voltage will drop. You'd think it might go up, but no, it actually goes down. So it might be, if your system is at risk of melting, this might go down closer to that figure we've seen of 11.4. If we remember that, that's the minimum one. You don't want it to get too low. So basically, once you know roughly what your input voltages are at normal, when you're gaming and stuff, you can then set up an alert below that and do something when your system drops down too much. So then the way you do that is at the bottom, you click on Configure Sensors, and then you go to Alerts, and you actually find your particular sensor. So it will be that one. And I've already set this up, so I'll just disable that a little bit. So yeah, GPU, PCI Express, plus 12 input voltage. There are other ones, but I tend to prefer the one that says plus 12 volts input voltage. And then you can set up an alert. So what you would basically do is you'd say enable alerting and do something if the value drops down too low. Now for this particular test, I'm just going to do 12.3 because my system is dipping down to that, so we can actually, you know, see something happening. There's a few things you could do. One of the things you could do is just play a sound and display a warning window. That could be something you might want to do. So for example, you might have that set up and, you know, I'll start using my system normally, and soon hopefully that warning will actually appear, because we know that, you know, often the voltage is dropping below that. There. And actually the warning has appeared, right? So you could do something like that, and if you get that when gaming or something like that, you know that something bad might be happening. And then you can take your side panel off and check your cables or anything like that. I'll link to another video I've done where I talk about all the things you can actually check, you know, non-destructively, in other words, not removing the cable. But in general, that actually proves that the alert does work, so that is quite a good thing. But obviously you might want to go a step further than just having a warning. You might actually want to shut down your system. There it is, it keeps kicking off now. You might want to actually shut down your system, you know, if that voltage drops down too low, and then you can look at things in more detail. So let's go back to those sensors. Let's find that particular sensor. What you might want to do instead is shut down your computer. Now, and the way you would do that is run a program, but it is key to note, you can't run a program and display that warning window, you know, because actually what can happen is that warning window will then stop your computer shutting down. Like you could see here, actually it's glitched up and that command hasn't fully run, see? So what you might want to do is disable, if you want to shut down your computer, disable the warning window, disable plain and sound, and the only thing you want to do is shut down your computer. So that's what it'll look like by default, and I'll put all this in the description anyway, but the command you want is to shut down your computer. So you would do that, and then do, oh hang on, let me raise that value, sorry, it's going to shut down my computer otherwise, so let me just do 11.6, I don't want it to shut down while I'm in the middle of doing this. So yeah, basically you would do run a program, shut down, you paste that in there, arguments dash s, which means immediately, and then that'll be it. And now if your system ever drops down below that, your computer will shut down automatically. And that's actually quite a nice thing to do. Hopefully that mini guide has helped you. But if you've got any further questions, please let me know down in the comments. And if you enjoyed this video or found it useful, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more short videos like this. Thanks for watching.